sketchy, a great deal of use in hostilities in the Soviet Union, when P-40 was again an excellent platform able to withstand operations in very low temperatures and do so reliably and effectively. Hack aircraft that was used by senior officers at Chinook Field in Kansas in this stripped natural metal finish from seasons gone by, including last September's Spitfire tail chase here at Duxford, and much more. The DVD cost £16.99, the Blu-ray £24.99 plus postage and packing. You can make your order and collect your free DVD stand, which has a big pennant outside saying DVD, and that can be found in its usual position, I believe, behind the row of static. And heard the Rolls-Royce Merlins of the Lancaster, Spitfire and Hurricanes earlier on, and indeed seen seven Hurricanes already. We now turn to an aero engine that was a predecessor of the Merlin, and an organ in R2. Straighter wings of the Fury 1 behind. Around the time of the Munich crisis of 1938, caused by the German annexation of the Sudetenland, that was really a sign with war looming that biplanes like these were becoming increasingly outmoded. The last in use is late in 1942, a Mark 1, used by 753 Squadron for weather check. Flown there by the South African Air Force. they scrap, much late for a tip-off from the RAF. To 802 Squadron, this particular example, such as the little value placed on such airframes after their retirement from service, that this one ended up on a municipal dump north of Ashford. It was discovered half buried, largely complete but significantly corroded. The remains were donated to the RAF Museum and put in storage. From there they were sold on. They ended up with Guy Blackwood Aero Vintage in the early 1990s. The Nimrod, which was sorted into the air from Duxford in November 2006. See aircraft like that Nimrod 2 and like that Fury 1.